So good morning. I'm Frederick County Executive Jan Gardner. I want to welcome you all here this morning. We are gathered to pay tribute to the loved ones who we have lost to COVID-19, as well as to honor our healthcare workers and our other essential workers in our community who stepped up to help other people during extraordinary times and a time of real uncertainty. Before we begin, I do want to acknowledge several elected officials who are with us today. First, we're very honored to have with us today our own U.S. Senator Chris Van Hollen, who'll be saying a few words this morning. So thank you for coming, Senator. Also from our federal delegation, we have Robin Summerfield, who's representing Senator Ben Cardin. We have Reagan Riley, who's representing Congressman Trone. And we have Joseph Young, who's representing Congressman Jamie Raskin. Also from the County Council this morning, we have our President of the Council, MC Keegan Ayer, Councilman Jerry Donald, Councilman Kai Hagan, and Councilman Steve McKay. So from our municipalities today, we are pleased to have Marion Brody Ennis from the town of Walkersville. Thank you, Marion. So I do want to thank everybody for coming out today. I know it's a hot day. We tried to have this early in the morning to beat the heat. So I vividly remember the day that coronavirus reached Frederick County. It was a Monday morning, March 16th, 2020. Our county health officer, Dr. Barbara Brookmeyer, stood by my side at a press briefing to break the news. 2 weeks later, the virus claimed its first life here. The person who died had been an active volunteer in our community, someone who touched the lives of many youth in Frederick County, and she was someone I knew personally. At that time, none of us knew or could know the devastation that lay in front of us. Our world and our day-to-day lives was changing dramatically, and it was a time of great uncertainty and even fear. Almost 2.5 years have passed since COVID was first discovered, and in some ways that seems like a lifetime ago. In Frederick County alone, there have been over 51,000 confirmed cases of COVID, and that number is likely higher because in recent months we've had most people testing with home tests, and they aren't reported and included in our numbers. And we know there are many people in our community who still struggle with the long-term effects of having COVID, and we've commonly come to refer to that as long COVID. Sadly, 526 of our friends, our neighbors, our family members have lost their lives to the virus, including one this past week. This is devastating to their families, to their coworkers, to their friends. And even in our Frederick County government, we have lost 3 of our employees to COVID over this time frame. So most of us know people who've had COVID, and we know people who've lost somebody to COVID. Now, the pandemic and its economic fallout have been intense. As with every challenge, though, the people of Frederick County have pulled together to help one another. And it's been amazing, and it's been inspiring. Our businesses, our nonprofits, our individual people, our government partners identified needs and worked together quickly to meet those needs. And I will say those needs changed and over time as to what we needed to do. We stood up 83 food distribution points, a mass vaccination effort, COVID testing, healthcare. We pivoted to meet the needs of the citizens in our community with rental assistance and with food and other needs. And I really have to give a big shout out to Frederick County government employees. Literally a third of our employees did a different job during some period of time during COVID to meet that community response. And of course, many people in our community did the same. So I'm really proud of the way our community responded. Certainly our essential workers in our community, our healthcare workers, people from all walks of life came together for the greater good. And I want to give thanks to the support of our federal delegation, certainly to Senator Van Hollen and to all of our representatives here today. We received millions of dollars in aid through the CARES Act and then the American Rescue Plan Act to help with our public health response and also to help lift our community, our businesses, our nonprofits, and individual families. That's where our rental assistance money came from. It's where a lot of the funds we used to make sure we could meet our community's needs. So we are very grateful for that money. It has made a huge difference to our community. And our economy in Frederick County is thriving, and it has proven to be very resilient. Physically, we're stronger as well. 89% of our residents have received at least one dose of the vaccine. That includes children under the age of 5. And I can say, as a grandmother of 3 young boys, I can tell you I'm happy to know that our children can be vaccinated and be better protected. Hospitalizations from COVID are now a bit lower than they were, far below our peak numbers in January, where at one point in time we had well over 100 people hospitalized at one time. And we have seen fewer people in the ICU over the last few months. And this is a testament to the power of the vaccine. The vaccines have really worked. They've really helped to make sure that people do not get severely ill, and they have reduced the number of deaths in our community and around our country. Physically and economically, we're certainly in a better place than we were a year and a half ago. But we do know that we still struggle with some needs. We know that mental health is a critical part of our community's recovery. We certainly need an opportunity to mourn and to mourn those that we've lost, a place to focus our grief, collect our thoughts, say a silent prayer, and a place of healing. And that's why this memorial was created. The idea also came from the citizens of Frederick County, the people who live and work in our community. In the spring of 2021, I asked the community to submit their ideas for how we could honor those who died from COVID. And we did have dozens of people provide responses and details of what they thought the memorial should look like. Many suggested a garden or a tree-lined pathway, a permanent living space where people could sit and quietly reflect, with benches and a plaque or some kind of engraving to remember the lives lost. Now, if you were one of those people who submitted a suggestion, I want to say thank you. Your contributions helped shape the memorial we will unveil in a few moments. I was particularly struck by the number of people who wanted our memorial to also recognize those who put their own safety at risk to help others. As one person put it, we need to honor the working class heroes who carried us through the pandemic, our frontline healthcare workers, our grocery store workers, our restaurant workers, those people who delivered food to our homes, our post office workers, our teachers, all those people in our community, and there are many of them, who kept us going. And I certainly agree with that. From our EMS providers, our nurses and doctors, to the delivery driver who brought our groceries, so many people came together and did their part and wanted to keep Frederick County going, really wanted to help other people. So before the unveiling, we're going to hear from Senator Van Hollen. And then after the Senator, Cheryl Chaffee, who is the Senior Vice President and Chief Operating Officer of Frederick Health, will say a few words, as will Dr. Randall Culpepper, our Frederick County Deputy Health Officer. Then we'll hear from our final speaker, who is Mr. Emilio Reed, who's sitting here in the front row, who chose to share his COVID story with our community in a video to encourage more people to get vaccinated. Following his comments, Angela Spencer will treat us to her rendition of Amazing Grace, and then we will unveil the memorial. Everyone will have an opportunity to view the engraving, which has different messages on each side, as well as words encircling the stone. Lauren and Vanessa of First Share Strings and the Double Time Duo have been providing us with music today as we will play again as we wrap up this morning. So thank you for being here. There are a number of other people I want to acknowledge and thanks for their roles in the development of this memorial. Mayor John Kennard of Thurmont, who couldn't be here today, and his daughter, Heather DeWeese, who is here today, sitting in the back of Kennard Memorial's Engrave the Stone. And I think it's really nice that we have a municipal mayor and his business and somebody who's really been a great community partner be able to provide that service to our community. The design of the long curved pathways and the trellis work and was done by Human and Rohde Landscape Architects, who designed many of our parks. Morgan Keller, Greensite, Barrick & Sons, and MK Concrete all helped to create this beautiful space today. From the county, I want to thank our project management staff and our Division of Public Works, particularly Kyle Baker, who led this effort. Let's give him a round of applause. I want to thank Jeremy Courtright, who's standing in the back, and his staff from the Division of Parks and Recreation, who help us find the perfect location here in our park. And they always do fabulous work. Our parks are beautiful in Frederick County. Our Division of Energy and Environment, under the leadership of Shannon Moore, who assisted with the replanting of trees that line the pathway. I also want to thank Heidi Keeney and Vivian Laxton from my office, who were instrumental in planning this memorial and today's event. And I want to acknowledge Frederick Electric. They'll be installing lights along the pathway once the parts arrive in a few weeks. So at this time, I am honored to invite our U.S. Senator, Chris Van Hollen, to speak. Thank you.
Thank you, Jan. It's an honor to join with all of you on this beautiful day, not too hot yet, to dedicate this memorial in this beautiful spot to those in our community that we lost to COVID. Loved ones, brothers, sisters, co-workers. It is fitting that we set aside this place to remember them and to reflect on those who are still suffering from COVID, and to express our gratitude to all the frontline healthcare workers and all the other frontline workers who put themselves at risk to help save others. That is what this memorial is all about. I want to thank your County Executive, Jan Gardner, for her extraordinary leadership here in Frederick County during good times, but especially her leadership during the tough times, during the COVID pandemic. She was there 24/7 trying to make sure that the citizens of Frederick County received the help and support that they did need. And I want to thank the members of the County Council, the community partners, the healthcare workers, hospitals, clinics, and everybody who went 24/7 to help their neighbors and to help others throughout our community. And on behalf of those of us at the federal level who represent Frederick County, my friend and colleague, Senator Ben Cardin, Congressman David Trone, Congressman Jamie Raskin, whose representatives are here, it was an honor to partner with all of you during those really tough times and continuing through this day. Because as County Executive Gardner said, all of us were working around the clock to try to make sure that we got the PPE where it was needed, to try to make sure we deployed vaccines more quickly and effectively, and to provide support to small businesses and others who are hurting, especially families and many who are out of work because of the pandemic. We did first pass the CARES Act, as County Executive Gardner said, and then in March of last year, President Biden signed the American Rescue Plan. And the American Rescue Plan has, in my view, a fitting name, Rescue, because that allowed us to deploy vaccines much more quickly, much more equitably, and to produce a lot more, and to produce the therapeutics that can help those who do have and get COVID. And that allowed them to deploy those throughout the country. It also, as the county executive said, provided funds at the state level and at the local level so that Frederick County could use those funds as it decided were best needed. Very flexible funds. Over $50 million of federal funds from the American Rescue Plan to the county and municipalities in the county, the mayors and the town councils, who worked to make sure that they put those monies where all of you decided was most needed in order to fight this virus. And as a result, we did save and have saved and continue to save thousands of lives. We're at a point here today where we haven't gotten rid of the virus. We know that. We know many people who have it. The President of the United States has the virus as we speak. But because of those efforts, because of the vaccines, because of the therapeutics, we have significantly reduced the number of people who are hospitalized and the number of people who die from COVID. So it's not over. in terms of the virus. We still need to be vigilant. We hope that the worst is over because of all the measures that everybody here took and people like all of you around the country. And so we need to keep at it. We need to keep at it to save lives. As county executive said, we lost a life in this community just recently. And there are people who still suffer from the impact of COVID. Despite all that progress, it is very important that we remember those that we were not able to save in time and those we continue to lose. Over 1 million Americans. Several months ago, we passed that terrible marker where over 1 million Americans lost their lives to COVID. People who we were not able to provide help to in time because we are in the process of trying to respond and develop. And we all have many lessons to learn as a country and communities in the event that something like this happens again. But part of making sure that we're ready for the next one is to remember those who we lost this time through this memorial, to remember those who are still suffering, and to thank those who were on the front lines responding. And that's what this memorial is all about. It's a place for all of us to come, to remember loved ones lost, to reflect on those who are still fighting with the after effects of COVID, and again, to thank our first responders, our hospitals, our healthcare workers, all those people who did put themselves at risk, who put their lives on the line to save the lives of others in our community. And it is a beautiful spot to come and reflect on that. So I'm very glad that Frederick County, County Executive, the County Council, decided to put this memorial here as a reminder of those lost and as a reminder of what we need to do going forward to save our fellow Americans and our loved ones. Thank all of you for being part of today and for being part of the fight against COVID. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much to Executive Gardner for allowing us to be here today to say a few words on behalf of Frederick Health. As you both have already stated so eloquently, we were certainly on the front lines of this, not knowing what to expect. I see at least one of our awesome team members here today who stood by and watched as this pandemic, you know, reached the front doors of the emergency department, out into our medical practices and clinics, not knowing how patients should be treated. They really stood on the front lines with significant bravery in the face of this and have continued to evolve over the past couple of years in the treatment of patients so that we can send people home with the appropriate treatments and keep them out of the hospital. So we're really proud of everything our organization has done. While Frederick Health is the largest healthcare provider in the county, the ongoing COVID-19 response has certainly been a team effort. We have had great partnerships with our local officials, of course, the health department, our partner agencies, and many citizen groups who have pulled together to deliver on this great response to the pandemic. Everyone played a role in helping to keep our community healthy, including those who even chose to go and get vaccinated to protect others, including themselves. Since the pandemic began, at the hospital, we have treated and released over 3,000 COVID-19 patients and provided hundreds of thousands of vaccines, boosters, and laboratory tests to see where the virus was spreading and to see what we could do to have early intervention. Frederick County has the third highest vaccination rate in the state, and that is a testament to our shared belief in science and our focus on bringing quality care to our community. Most importantly, I wanted to offer a heartfelt thank you to the entire Frederick Health team, from our lab staff to our community health workers, our critical care team, and our facility staff. Every individual on our 4,500 member team, including all of our physicians and medical providers, played an important role. I'm really pleased that this dedication today is not only memorializing the lives that have been lost, but the heroes who stood here and helped protect this county. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you, County Executive, for letting us come and share in this opportunity. I really appreciate that a lot. 2 years, 4 months, 7 days ago on March 16th, as you heard from County Executive, a 35-year-old healthy female became our first case of COVID-19 in Frederick County. By the end of that month, just 2 weeks after that first case was identified, we already had 29 cases and 2 fatalities in the county. By the middle of April, only 4 weeks after the virus arrived here, we had 394 cases and 13 fatalities. 13 fatalities in the first month of COVID arriving in Frederick County. Our most vulnerable citizens during this pandemic have been our most fragile and elderly residents, many living in our long-term care facilities. Sometimes we are tested not to show our weaknesses, but to discover strengths. This is especially true for all of our long-term care facility workers, our public health professionals, our hospital staff, our fire and rescue workers, and our healthcare providers in the community. These are our heroes, many of whom frequently put themselves in danger of exposure to the virus, but most profoundly, because of COVID restrictions, were often the only ones to be at the patient's bedside, caring for the ill, and watching the last breath of those who died. As of yesterday, we've had 526 deaths in Frederick County. We are still engaged in a great war against these viruses, testing whether our nation, so conceived in liberty, can long endure. We are here today to dedicate this memorial to all of those who have suffered and died, God bless their souls, as well as those healthcare heroes and essential workers who still toil endlessly and often risk their own safety to care for others. We must not forget the toll this pandemic has taken and the impact it's had on every one of us who are here today. Always on our minds, forever in our hearts, we will continue to face COVID-19 together as a community. We have spread our wings. We have flown like eagles. We've done the very best we know how. We've done the very best we can. And we mean to keep on doing so until the end. On behalf of Dr. Barbara Brookmeyer, our County Health Officer, thank you for having us today. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Good morning. Thank you for inviting me to tell my story. My name is Amelia Reed, and I was an essential worker during a pandemic. And last March 2021, I tested positive for COVID, and I was hospitalized at Frederick Health, 53 days in ICU, a total of 90 days in total rehab, and it's still a struggle. Now I've been diagnosed with pulmonary fibrosis, so the battle will continue. It doesn't end, it continues. I would like to thank my wife, for one, for when they told her that I only had a 2% chance in surviving, she didn't give up. You did not. I would also like to thank Frederick Health for, I can't express the amount of gratitude that I have to all the, from the emergency room, nurses, doctors, therapists. You guys did not give up on me either. Thank you very much. I also like to thank Brooke with Love for Lachlan for putting my story out there that there's many of us. All of us have a story to tell, but there's the battle and the struggle continue, especially now that I'm considered a long COVID hauler. We got a lot of work to do for all these people. So, therefore, thank you so much for having me out here. And again, thank you so much, Frederick Health. You guys need to be appreciated a whole lot more for the work that you guys do. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. It is always an honor to be able to stand before you to share. I'm Angela Spencer, retiree of Frederick County Government. Thank you so very much. But also most recently, they said, you're crazy. I retired one day and I started another job the next. But Dr. Mandel, I would have to say that it has been one of the most rewarding positions that I've ever had. I served as your vaccine program coordinator with Frederick Health Hospital in the Asian American Center. And as everyone has said, every day, somewhere in this community, there was someone on the front lines doing something to help someone else. And for that, as she stated, we are number three in the state of Maryland. So I still celebrate that. I don't know if we're quite at a complete 80% yet, but you know, we're continuing to climb, Sean. We're almost there. But today I stand before you to ask you to reflect and to remember as I sing the lyrics of Amazing Grace. As I shared with Vivian, it's not just a number on a screen. Now we all have a face and a name. Amazing Grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear. The hour I first believed, through many dangers, toils, and snares, Frederick, we have already come. 'Twas grace that brought us safe thus far, and grace will lead us on. Amen. Thank you.
I now ask the county council members to come join me for the unveiling. I would like all the speakers to come down for a photo after, and I'd invite all of you to come down and spend a few moments viewing the memorial. Thank you.